Hello and welcome everybody. My name is Gracie and I will show you guys today how to do Kashmir's Supersaw synths. He used it in his tracks Bazaar and also in Mandala. Yes, first let's listen to the original. First let's listen to Bazaar, to the Supersaw theme. Sounds like this. Yes, most of you will know it. And what I'm going to show you will sound like this. I also prepared a mandala. It's actually even in the same key. And the synth is also pretty similar. So first let's listen to the original of Mandala. And now to what I have done. Yes. What this tutorial is about, I will not show you how to turn every knob in the synthesizer itself, but how I did the layering and mixing and the effects and which tricks I used and stuff. But yes, let's start right away. Most of the times, so even when I want to write the MIDI of an existing song, I start with the bass. Well, then you have the basis of the chords. In this case, we have the song Bazaar, for example, is in E minor. And the MIDIs are actually, you can download the MIDIs for free. I have a link in the video description. You can also download the silent presets. I used silent all over this project. Yes. So this the bass synth sounds like this. I hope you can hear it. Yes, and let's see how the bass is layered. Of course, there is a sub. I also added the sub to the download folder. Well, nothing special about the sub. It's a sine wave, minus one octave. Nothing, no effects or something like this. Here's a reverb, but it's switched off. I will delete it right away. Then there is a, I called it dist because it sounds distorted and also very noisy and crunchy. I called it bass layer 1. It's also in the download folder. I added a camel crusher here just to make it to distort it a bit and to make it a bit louder and fatter. I also EQ'd this layer, cut out the subs because we have a sub, we don't need them here in this layer, and also raised some mids for the sound pretty good. So then I have an attack layer. The attack layer is nothing more than just a noise. What I did here, it's just a white noise. oscillator here, and this trick here down here with the envelope, I do this all the time. If you want to get more attack to the synth, you can put an envelope over the pitch here like this, and you pull all triggers down, but the decay slightly up. So what this means is it will start at high pitch and go down very quickly. It's just like a kick works basically, and we can modify this knob here. The higher you put the decay up, the slower the pitch will go from up to down, and so I wanted to go really fast to have just this clicking attack. Yes, and I have another layer also distorted, and but not that noisy, so I take this for the mids, you can see, and this for the lows, and this for the sub, and this for the attack. Yeah, so this is a 2-hour bass. If you want to recreate it afterwards, I made a silent bank for you, and it looks like this. And if you want, for example, want to recreate the bass, just make 4 silent instances, and you have the 4 layers here. I named everything beautifully. Yeah, that's it to the bass. Nothing special here. Then I added the chords. I love the chords. The chords are great. And he used a really, really fat synth here. I couldn't recreate it like 1-to-1, but yeah, close enough, I would say. So listen to the chords only. And what you hear now, this is only the synthesizers without the reverb. I made the reverb in a separate channel here, but we will get later to it. First, let's have a look to the different layers of the chord synths. Yes, I named it. First, I have this noisy mid chord, I called it. It has some also distortion and noise. Open the silent up. And what I did to all the chord synths is I put the sustain all the way down, because it's a really choppy chord theme. So what this means, when I put the sustain down, it doesn't hold the tone when you play the chord, but it punches it, and then it goes down, the volume goes down. So the decay to about middle, and we can try it out for better understanding. If I would put the decay down, it would just shortly play the chord, so I wanted to just play for a short time and then go away, so that you have the kind of choppy effect. I also added this pitch envelope again for better attack, because it's all about attack in this with this super sauce. The second layer is a bit higher, 1 octave higher. I think it's pretty similar, the synth itself, but it's just playing an octave higher. So this was the previous one. Actual one. Yes, the preferences are pretty similar. I have here always 8 voices playing and stereoscopic. Very much detuned, so that you have this signature synthes super saw effect. Yes, as I said, if you want to go in detail about this synthesizers itself, you can download my presets and have a look. So this is the second layer, the third layer. Because there was some kind of belly organ sound in his super saw, so I was searching for such presets. I didn't make the preset myself. I was just searching through my banks and found what sounded similar and changed it a bit. So this is my third layer. Yeah, that's how it sounds when you put the three layers together. I also cutted out the lows. I did not much EQing as a whole, I just wanted to show the basic stuff, how it's done. Yes, and as I said, this is just the dry chords and synths. I have a separate chord layer here, chord channel, reverb channel. How this works is you make a new audio track, then you can choose here the audio input, where the audio should come from. Because I'm not playing an instrument here, it just should take the audio from my chord synths and make a reverb. So I put here chords, I set it to pre-FX, which means it gets the audio before it gets out of the channel, so I can solo this reverb even if the actual synth is not playing, at least we can't hear it. So we can now listen to the only to the reverb, which is really cool. Sounds pretty weird if you play only the reverb. The plugin I used for the reverb, I really love this one, is Valhalla Vintage Verb. There is a preset in it called Huge Synth Space. I modified it a bit. Really sounds cool. And gives it a huge space. And I added a compressor there. Why did I add a compressor to the reverb? Because so it's used as a sidechain compressor. And I added it because so actually I do this really often in my projects. I added it because I only want the verb to play when the actual synth stops to play. So when the synth plays, the reverb should be more silent. When the synths stop playing, the reverb should go up. So this is how it sounds with the reverb. The reason why I do this is because when the verb has always the same loudness, then it gets kind of mixed with the synth, and you lose the attack of the synth, and you have just one, don't know how to say it, but yeah, if you really want to keep the attack of the synth and the actual feeling from the synth, and also want to add huge space to it, it's a really cool trick to add a reverb in a separate channel, and then you can add a sidechain to it. For the sidechain source, I of course use the chord audio. So you can see when the chord is playing, it compresses the reverb down, and when the chord is not playing, reverb goes up. So that's to the chords. Let's go to the main lead here. Yes, actually pretty easy lead, but very effective melody. Let's listen to it. Yes, what I did here, it has actually four layers. I did the trick with the reverb, so I have a separate channel for the lead verb. The first layer I called noisy again, because it's really noisy. And this is what makes it sound warm, the whole super saw, if you add a nice noise to it. But really, it's better that just one layer has this noise sound in it than if you have all the layers playing some different kinds of noises. So if you just have one or let's say two layers of the synth that are playing the noises, yes, it sounds nice and warm. So I have the noise layer. Again, really simple. If you download my silent bank I prepared, I have here the four layers for you. Then the second layer is, I call it distort. At first it was more distorted, but then it became a bit nicer. This is actually a layer that has very much detune, because yes, it sounds more aggressive if you have one layer playing more detuned, and also added some distortion to it. Again, the trick with the pitch envelope. The third layer I called brassy because it reminded me of a trombone sound or something, because the first two layers are really high pitched and are in the high frequencies. I added this brassy lead, which is playing a bit lower, also has a nice punch. Yes, here I put the sustain all the way up because I wanted one layer to not stop playing, but hold the note a bit longer, so that it's not so cut off the melody. Yeah, this was a preset too, I modified it. And again, just an attack layer, which has a white noise with low decay time, no sustain, no release, and again this pitch envelope just for the attack. I can give this EQ away, it's just cutting off the lows with this does also. So let's listen to the whole chord layer. Again, I cut it off the lows and pushed the highs a little bit and added a camel crusher to the, but only to the dry signal. And that's also really cool when you have the lead separated, you can process the dry signal in a separate way and the verb in a separate way. It's really cool. I use it almost every time. And that you have kind of a second multiphonic synth, polyphonic, don't know how to say, doesn't matter. Just like it's just playing the melody rhythm, but in a different with different notes. So with the main lead, it sounds like this. I don't know if you can even hear it. Yes. This is not the original voice, but I found I should add some polyphonic here. So the second lead, yes, can delete this. I call it second lead. It has only two layers. Again, a super saw layer here. Oh, I forgot to use my bank here, but it's also added in my bank, don't worry. Okay, so that's pretty much it to the sound. Let's have a listen again to the whole thing. We'll be right back. Okay, and what I also added is here a top loop. It's actually even from Kashmir's sample pack, Sounds of Kashmir 2, I think. He has some two really good sample packs. I really recommend buying them. You can download them on Splice, I think, splice.com. Just clap and hi-hat stuff. Let's listen again to Mandala. Yes, so that's it. I would like to say thank you for watching. And by the way, you can download the synth presets. Link is in the download description. You just have to like my Facebook page. And you can also download the MIDIs. I prepared the MIDIs for you. And yeah, have fun recreating the synth.